Everyone here at the Goodyear Airship Operations Center would like to welcome you aboard. You'll be an integral part of the team that ensures the safe and efficient operation of our Goodyear Airship, the Spirit of America. There are many aspects that govern the operation of the Goodyear Airship, and safety is the most important rule of all. In order to ensure your personal safety, as well as ensure the safety of the team and the airship, we're going to go over basic operations here at Goodyear when working around the airship. As a member of the ground operations team, you will be responsible for one of many tasks associated with the safe operations of the Goodyear airship and its passengers. The first thing we want to go over are the core safety precautions you must always exercise, regardless of what position you will be assigned. If you fall down, stay down. Never let your feet leave the ground. Walk wide around the propellers. Goodyear requires all crew members to wear personal protective equipment, steel-toed shoes, hearing protection, eye protection, and gloves. If you fall down, stay down. Never let your feet leave the ground. Walk wide around the propellers. Wear your safety gear when around the airship, and always keep your eye on the ground handler. The check signal is used to hold the nose of the airship in its current position. When the ground handler needs to move the airship port or starboard, he will give the pull signal in the direction he wants the airship to go. When the ground handler is getting a way off, he will ask for the lineman to slack the lines, which takes the load off the nose, giving the ground handler a more accurate way off. When the airship does sporting or TV events, the lineman at the end of the rope will run and attach the rope to cleats on the handrail, just before the airship takes off. When the airship is locked on the mast, the ground handler will yell "locked" while giving the lock signal. This lets the crew know they can release the lines and car. A wave off is used when the landing of the airship is aborted. It is important to watch out for the nose lines, propellers, and tail lines as the airship is passing.
When preparing the airship for flight, it is the crew's responsibility to remove all the ground support equipment. Each piece of ground support equipment is vital to the airship. Never walk behind the propellers unless you are absolutely sure that the magnetos are off and that the engines are not about to run. At the command to stand by, the mast climber will release the pin from the mast cup. After pin has been released, the ground handler will give the command trip. Tripping is releasing the airship from the mast. Always be aware of weather conditions prior to undocking the airship. Please do everything as safe as possible and be aware of others around you. So if you have any questions, ask the crew chief or any experienced crewman around.
When the airship is approaching the landing area, all crew members need to be in formation and ready for the landing. When the airship is landing, the entire crew will line up in a V formation, with the V lineup pointing into the wind direction. This lets the pilot know when he is coming into land what the wind direction is. As a lineman, you will stand the furthest away from the ground handler. When instructed by the ground handler, the lineman will run out towards the airship, take hold of the respected lines, and run outward from the nose of the airship. They will then slide down until they reach the end of the rope. Linemen need to always be aware of the ground handler's hand signals while the airship is on the ground. Always keep both hands on the rope at all times. Linemen are to be arm's length from each other while the ship is on the ground. When the airship is on the ground, the linemen will move forward so that their lines are approximately at a 90 degree angle to the nose of the airship. To launch the airship, the linemen will wait for the ground handler to let go of the lines to always walk away from the nose when the pilot is given the power signal. To raise the mast, the first step is to open the steel doors that cover the mast trough. Once all of the steel doors are open, the gym pole and gym pole rope assembly is removed from the trough. The crew member who removes and sets up the gym pole rope assembly must hold onto the rope until the mast is fully erected. After the jim pole is set up, the primary cables, or long cables, are to be removed from each side of the mast. A minimum of two people is required for each primary cable bundle. Cables should be placed together and free of kinks at approximately 45 degrees from the mast. When raising the mast, crew members need to hold on the rope with both hands. When directed by the ground handler, crew members will pull on the rope until the mast is raised. A slow and steady motion is the safest way for the mast to rise. Do not let go of the rope until directed by the ground handler. The ground handler will direct the crew in the attachment of all cables. Crew members not working the four mains need to leave their cables slacked. After the main cables are secure and tight, the crew members will take all of the slack out of the rest of the cables. The ground handler will then proceed to have the crew members tighten the intermediate or short cables. After the intermediate cables are tightened, the primary or long cables will follow. All cable tensions should be tightened as tight as possible. Before fueling, the car needs to be properly grounded with the grounding cable and the fuel hose connected. There needs to be enough slack in the grounding cable and fuel hose to allow for some movement. When fueling from the bowser, it is important that the crew members not working the fuel pump or fuel hose hold the car steady.
If you have any questions, please talk with other members of the crew or review this video again. Your safety is key to the successful operation of the Goodyear Blimp and the team that operate it. Welcome aboard.